Quinn Dickey Show, Season 2. Christo, the Grand Duke of Lentois, Prince Mama Walden, motherfucker, that's Blackula. I'm the PPP loan scamming destroyer. I'm the talented Mr. Dickey, y'all. And today's show, shit, first, Happy New Year. But today's show is gonna be something I should have touched on all last year, but I didn't. Came to my motherfucking mind. I'ma address it. Hopefully this one will be a good one and fun one for y'all. How's everybody doing? Yeah. It's Monday. I thought it was Sunday because I took the day off. But yeah, it is Monday. I didn't go to work and I'm glad because it's like negative fucking 50 degrees out here in Colorado. It's a trip. A trip. I hate the cold. I always hated the cold as a kid. The whole nine. I remember going in the damn ditch, slipping on that motherfucker and busting my fucking lips and shit and all that. But welcome to the Quint Dickey Show. This is starting off season two. I'm going to be dropping them every Sunday in rotation. So we just going to get this shit going. We're going to just, you know, have a good time, talk about some real shit, grown shit, the whole nine. So today's show, broadcast, whatever the fuck you want to call it, is called The Right Hand of the Klan. And what I mean by that is the right hand of the Ku Klux Klan. And a lot of people should really listen to this because it's breaks down excuses. You're doing no fucking excuses. It's 2024. Fuck the excuses. Okay? Fuck that. When I talk about the right hand of the Klan, I'm talking about us as a people doing shit that you say the white man is holding you down, doing this and that. And it's not. You know what I mean? It's not. It's your own actions. You know what I mean? It's your actions. It's you doing dumb clown shit that is synonymous to the people you complain about, the Klan, right? Let's jump into this. First, I want to tell you a story, like I always do, okay? So let me start the music. Ooh. Let that sink in for a minute. Okay, check it out. Yeah, I know y'all thought I was gonna start rapping. I don't know more. But let me tell you a story about some shit I seen. When I was a youth, and I love telling y'all stories about when I'm young, you know what I mean? Because it's experiences that I've been through to make me talk about this shit as an adult now. But I'm young. My mom comes all the way here from Fort Walton Beach, Florida. I'm not going to say the name of the place where she got us in. You know me, you know. But it's fun. A lot of activities going on. You know what I mean? We're just being kids, doing our thing. And they ask, do you want to go to Sunday school, church? And I wind up going to Sunday school a couple times. Great. About a month or so goes by, waiting for the church bus. We get on the church bus. I'm figuring it's just a regular day. I'm a little kid, probably like 6 or 7. Excuse me. And I see two of the older boys. I don't know if it was fresh testosterone or what, but two of the older boys start breaking out in almost a fight. And I remember that's the first time I see it. You know what I'm saying? And I remember being a youngin', and I'm looking and I'm fucking like real deal kind of scared. It fucked me up. Like, what, you know what I mean? What are these dudes doing? You know what I'm saying? But what could you do? You know what I'm saying? You couldn't stop them. And I'm wondering why they're going at each other like that. You know what I'm saying? These are two brothers. You know what I'm saying? Not brothers, but brothers. You know what I mean? Same color, the whole nine, right? Now, fast forward a little bit. I get more into my, teenage years. And I'm seeing more and more of that. You know what I mean? Go to the channel, knock the bitch out. You know what I mean? Motherfuckers is fighting. I mean, motherfuckers is really fighting. And it goes to the tune of motherfucking, we are shooting one another, hurting the fuck out of each other. And where I'm from, there aren't too many whites there. You know what I'm saying? Doing this stuff to us, hurting us. And this is no pass to all white people or anything like that. This is strictly the right hand of the Klan. And I'm looking at these motherfuckers like, okay, y'all are hurting each other. Okay? And as I get older, I'm seeing it more and more and more. All right? Fast forward now, we're 2024, so this is well over 30 years, and it's the same thing, okay? Motherfuckers hurting each other, making stupid ass decisions, but really nobody was there to hold you back, okay? And when I say the right hand of the Klan, I'm talking about, well, your first and foremost, I'm gonna attack is the conscious community, the Hotep. All that shit, right? Swear up and down, they're about black empowerment, black enlightenment, and shit like that. And I've come to fucking realize that it's just, you know what I mean? On the real, some people are gonna be like, man, fuck you, or wanna fight me, or whatever, but I really feel like it's a bunch of bullshit. Because on the real, the conscious motherfuckers is real deal worried about getting booty. They worried about bitches, you know what I'm saying, hitting on these single moms or getting motherfucking bitches pregnant. Then they leap into motherfucking, oh, let's go ahead and be polygamous. I want more than one wife and shit. You can't even fucking take care of yourself. Let's be real. You can't even take care of yourself. And you talking about 2 or 3 wives? On the strength of that, I really think it's because you want 2 or 3 women to work and take care of you. Motherfuckers is lazy as fuck, man. And it always on some motherfucking PPP scamming loan shit. They always on some motherfucking, I'll sell your ass a damn lemon shit, you fucked up crooked car salesman and shit, on the strength. These are my experiences with it, you know what I'm saying? And it's all been bullshit. I'm not easily swayed into bullshit at all. You know what I'm saying? And if you do fool me, you fool me once, fuck no, you won't fool me again. You know what I'm saying? If you try to fool me a third time, I might try to, yeah. Just like that. But I'm gonna talk about this guy, Brother Polite. Gonna be the first motherfucker I attack tonight, and it is an attack. Oh well. But this shit right here is a right hand of the Klan shit. You check it out and see what he did. First clip, fair use. This is for educational purposes, and these are my opinions, the whole nine. Let me put that up there. Let me put my fair use up because motherfuckers will try to flag this shit. We'll try to get that motherfucker taken down. So this is the first clip. Check this shit out. Cause I was like, damn, man, you really though? You really doing that? Oof. It's a bad one. It is a bad one. Check it out.
The social media influencer and motivational speaker is making headlines for the wrong reason. NBC 6 reporter Kim Nguyen is live in Miami Beach tonight with more on the arrest of the man known as Brother Polite. Kim.
Yeah, well, Juwan, the suspect surrendered here at the Miami Beach Police Department earlier this week. Police charged him with sexual battery of a 14-year-old girl. We did speak with his lawyer earlier tonight, who says that these charges are false.
This is the mugshot of 37-year-old Michael Nowak Jr., also known as Brother Polite, to his more than 300,000 Instagram.
Let me stop it right there real quick. Did you see that motherfucker? Look at this shit. Motherfucker's real life. Let me back it up just a touch. Boom.
So known as Brother Polite to his more than 300.
Oh shit.
As Brother Polite. Also known as Brother Polite to his more than.
I can't even get the motherfucker to stop on this fool. Right there. Woo. Ooh wee. So you gonna tell me that you look at this motherfucking freak, and I'm not talking about freaking a good way when it's between two motherfucking consenting adults doing their thing, right? But look at this motherfucker, okay? And I'll get into health and all that shit in a second, but you know what I mean, right hand of the Klan clown shit is like this type of shit. This the type of motherfucker that'll really talk you into. You'll let a motherfucker like this talk you into giving your last dollar. You'll let this motherfucker talk you into a fucking PPP loan and shit. For real. Let's see what he did. Come on. Keep going.
Mugshot of 37-year-old Michael Nowak Jr., also known as Brother Polite, to his more than 300,000 Instagram followers. Miami Beach police arrested Nowak this week for alleged sexual battery of a 14-year-old girl in a hotel room in February. Police say the alleged victim was the daughter of a woman he was romantically linked to. Defense attorney David Terrace says his client is innocent.
Once the evidence is produced, that he is going to be exonerated. So yeah, not guilty, nothing else.
According to the police report, Nowak, a motivational...
Look at that clown shit. They say he a motivational speaker, right? He motivationally spoke his ass right into a motherfucking single mom's household and took the daughter. You know what I'm saying? Motherfucker wanted the daughter. You know what I mean? Did no white man do that. You know what I mean? Not at all. Don't want to hear that bullshit. Right hand of the Klan shit right here. Right here. Come on. We'll keep that shit going.
An author who lives in L.A. asked the woman if he could take her daughter to an after party at a club in Miami. The report states Nowak took the teen to his hotel after seeing that the club was closed. Police say the suspect gave the teen alcohol and started dancing and touching the teen inappropriately, groping her breast, inner thighs, and buttocks. It goes on to say Nowak tried to force the teen to perform oral sex on him. The teen allegedly passed out and woke up to Nowak trying to make her throw up.
These are serious allegations, but in any situation, there is always motive. There is always...
And this motherfucker right here, his lawyer looked like a motherfucking terrorist. A domestic T. My bad. I don't think you can say that shit, right? Somebody gonna flag this motherfucking video. I don't think you can say that shit. Look at this motherfucker. Look at the thick ass eyebrows and shit. You know what I'm saying? This motherfucker got the Sprinter van full of dynamite in that motherfucker. Keep it going.
A lot behind the scenes that the public is not going to be able to see.
The report states that the girl's mother found her intoxicated and possibly on drugs, with severe swelling on her mouth and lips. It later states Nowak told the mother not to call police because it would ruin his career.
He didn't want nobody to know he's a motherfucking freak like that. He did not want nobody to know. Right hand of the Klan shit. You see that shit? 14-year-old girl, you a motivational speaker and shit. And I remember these motherfuckers all around the internet posting shit on this motherfucker. He talked him into getting, like, loans, these stupid-ass loans and shit with the crib and saying that, you know what I mean, that basically they're for free and shit and you can get all these fucking multiplexes and shit and all this crazy shit. And I'm like, come on, man, like, don't listen to this motherfucker. Every time that there's a fast-talking motherfucker that fucking scared money don't make money, what else they be saying? That's the one. Scare money don't make money and shit. And they usually don't have any fucking money, you know what I mean, for themselves and shit. They're usually the ones, you know what I'm saying? All that fast talking shit and, you know what I mean, trying to get people to do shit for you for free, all of that, it's some bullshit, you know what I mean? That's some right hand of the Klan shit. Straight up, you know what I mean? Straight the fuck up. Come on, we're gonna keep it going.
Nowak was served with a DNA warrant in June and surrendered to police on Monday. Terrace says the police report is only an allegation. And Nowak claims to have written more than 90 books. In an interview, he also claims to have several wives.
Yeah. You know what I mean? Claiming to 90 books. Any motherfucker can be book smart and shit, but they'll be common sense is just wrecked. You know what I mean? Like, if you made that type of money and your motive was to get, like, a young child to do shit with, and you on the conscious shit, you know what I'm saying? Hotep or whatever the fuck that bullshit is. Motherfucker, you just as bad as the Epstein them. You know what I'm saying? You're just as bad as that shit. Straight up. And they got hella videos with this motherfucker. We gonna do another one. Another Hotep bullshit. And I've noticed too, back growing up, these motherfuckers right here, like this brother Polite and these other motherfuckers, another motherfucker I'm about to show you, they was never into it with gang members. Never. If you really about that shit, you know what I mean, about black empowerment and shit like that, they never ever, like, told these motherfuckers shit, nothing. They was always off to the side. They didn't want no smoke with them motherfuckers and shit. You know what I mean? At all. If you about blacks, you will stop the motherfuckers doing bullshit to blacks. But they didn't stop that because they doing bullshit to blacks. Right hand of the Klan. For real. Check it out. This is the second one.
The wife of a reported cult.
There we go. Yeah. Yeah. This shit right here is a trip. Check it out. Let me clear you this motherfucker up. Check this shit out.
The wife of a reported cult leader wants to tell her side of the story, and it's an interview you only see on 11 Alive. Elegio Bishop, also known as Nature Boy, is still in jail, facing charges that also include rape. His wife tells our Paula Soro he forced her to marry him after 3 years of knowing each other.
Forced?
I feel that now, looking back, I feel that I fell in love with an idea because he pretended to be someone that he wasn't.
Behind this smiling face, Velvet Marquez faced her hardest years next to Elegio Bishop.
He literally held me hostage. He took all of my identification, my passport, my birth certificate, my social, my bank cards, everything, you name it. Medical documentation.
She says Bishop, the leader of the so-called cult, Carbon Nation, went from spoiling her to abusing her when she got pregnant.
I was forced to engage spoiling in sexual activity that I did not want to do. I was still strangled on multiple occasions. So I had to, like, willingly engage in these sexual activities because of to keep myself safe. He would have...
So let me tell you what I know about, or what the little bit I know about this, because I wanted this other dude was clowning the shit out of him. And what I know about this fool is he started like a little camp or some shit where these motherfuckers was wanting to go and supposedly live off of the motherfucking land, nobody working shit. And don't get it fucked up, don't get it fooled. This chick right here, you know what I'm saying, these conscious bitches, they lazy as a motherfucker too. Believe that shit. They want to just sit back and chill, and you know what I mean, like she said, she was in love with a fucking idea. And this motherfucker, the idea was to just not work, not progress, just sit around and shit, you know what I mean, at this place, living off the land, no running water, nothing. You know, them motherfuckers was funky than a bitch. You know what I'm saying? I'm good on that shit. You know what I'm saying? I like progressing around this motherfucker. If motherfuckers say, oh, it's the white man's way and this and that, I really don't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? Like, I like paying my bills and being able to have a crib with the heat on, especially with minus 11 degree weather out here. Fuck all that dumb shit. Come on.
In front of the women.
She had their daughter in 2019, and a year and a half later, she says he forced her to legally marry him in a Las Vegas chapel.
There was no medical attention given to us, so when I actually went into labor, I had to be rushed to the hospital 2 hours away.
For years, the cult would drive and settle across Central America. Velvet says Bishop lived off of other members' PPP loans and life savings.
What the fuck did I just say? $3,000
college fund, while others gave tens of thousands of dollars. And after four tries, she successfully ran away with their daughter with no money but hope.
My child is important.
That bitch bad.
I don't understand how anybody could leave their child to be with him or to go live with him.
That bitch mad. That bitch mad as shit. She mad because the shit didn't go the way that she wanted it to go. At all. And it was because, you know what I mean, she wanted that damn, that life of motherfucking being the head wife and shit like that. You know, motherfuckers is crazy as fuck doing that shit. It's clown shit, you know what I mean? It shows no progression, no real progression of black folks, you know what I'm saying? And they try to shit on the Cosby Show because he showed motherfucking, you know what I mean, himself being a brother, real deal, raising a family out here, you know what I'm saying? Where we at, we in the United States. Yeah, shit has been fucked up for us. It has been. I'll be the first motherfucker to tell you that. But as shit progressed and shit, you know what I mean? The ways of this world, I mean, sorry, the ways of this country and shit like that, motherfuckers got what the fuck you need in resource, man. We got internet, all that shit, man. There's so much shit you can do to progress out here. Motherfucker, if you don't, you just don't want to. You know what I mean? If you want to be ignorant, that's voluntarily, if you want to be ignorant as fuck. You know what I'm saying? That is. There's nobody fucking sitting there secretly holding your ass down. Yeah, there's some covert motherfucking racism where motherfuckers try to block you and shit like that, but you gonna let them block you? Are you gonna let them block you? I'm not gonna let no motherfucker block me. Fuck that. You know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna let one thing block me. I'm gonna go out there and get that shit. No matter how many of these motherfuckers got to burn through, and I burned through a lot of them. Believe that. I done had it to where motherfuckers give the meth-headed dude contracts before me and shit, and I know why, or they're not as critical on their work, but they're critical as fuck on mine, and my shit is fucking got the glow. Believe that. I get it. But are you gonna motherfucking sit there and let that define you, hold you down the whole nine? I'm not. Fuck that. Not me. And I'm damn sure not gonna listen to these motherfuckers like this. You know what I mean? There's no way. No way. And let me get into another one. Yeah. This is some bullshit right here.
Thanks.
Why is that? Also, Klan shit is how you bring up the youth, man. You know what I'm saying? And I'm not ever, I will never tell nobody to bring up no motherfucker to be in servitude to no motherfucker. Bring them up to be weak. But damn, bring them up to be motherfucking respectful, strong. Talk softly, man. Carry a real big stick. Straight up. And I'll never do no shit like this. This next clip right here is, this is real shit. This is fair use. It's some bullshit. But I gotta show you. I gotta fucking show you. This is what you don't do, and this is what you don't show your kids, and this is what you don't raise. Here it is.
Forced to break up a brawl among parents and coaches at a youth football game Monday night.
Two people have already been charged, and now police say more charges could be coming. Fox 5's Doug Evans has the story.
Hey, stop! Stop!
That's police body cam video of a fight following a Troop County Parks and Rec youth football game Monday night. Police say a mother confronted a coach and county rec official when they say her son was not allowed to play because he had not attended practices and the family had not paid the required program fees.
They approached the coach and started threatening him. Someone threw blows. They started fighting. Several people joined in on the fight, and our officer that was on scene was overwhelmed by the amount of people, and he called for assistance.
The chief says the family involved in the fighting does not live in Hogansville, but resides in Troop County. They say the situation escalated and Hogansville police called for help from neighboring departments when the crowd moved out to the parking lot and tempers flared again. They say they were forced to tase a 17-year-old girl who they say was fighting and wouldn't stop. Police say they filed charges against 38-year-old Panika Tigner and 17-year-old Markeisha Reeves. They say they will have increased police presence at future youth football games and will issue criminal trespass warrants against anyone charged that will prevent them from attending games or using park property.
As parents and as adults, we are responsible for setting the example for the children that are there playing. They're there to have fun. An event like this does not set a very good example for the children that we're trying to mentor in these sports programs.
All out brawl. And I want to go back to what he said at the beginning. Back that up.
And video of a fight following a Troop County Parks and Rec youth football game Monday night. Police say a mother confronted a coach and county rec official when they say her son was not allowed to play because he had not attended practices.
So he didn't attend in practice.
The family had not paid the required program fees.
And they didn't pay the fees. But motherfucker, you gonna let my motherfucking kid play? Period, point blank. He gonna fucking play. I don't give a fuck if he didn't show up for practice like everybody else. I don't give a fuck if he didn't pay the fee. He gonna fucking play. Period. Right? So you get this entire brawl started. It's on the news. You done made fucking 5 o'clock news. That's right hand of the Klan shit. You know what I mean? I don't give a fuck. That is right hand of the Klan shit. You know what I mean? So you set this example in what the little kid's gonna grow up to be. What the little kid's gonna grow up to start showing out like. For real, what the fuck they gonna start showing out like? Because if mom, dad, you show them that, they gonna go into the whole fucking world thinking that they can act like that. You know what I mean? On the real. They gonna think they can act like that. So, more right hand of the Klan shit, man. It really is. It's some bullshit, man. And I already know motherfuckers gonna see this video. Uncle Tom, Coon, all that shit. You motherfuckers say that shit. I guarantee you won't say it to my fucking face. I guarantee you that shit. You go on this motherfucker, you'll try to flag this bitch, all of that. No, I get it. But all year, man, I'm calling out Klan shit all fucking year. You know what I'm saying? and this is going to be a series started, man. This is going to be part one. Those are just three examples. I just wanted to do something real quick on it, but straight up, there will be a part two of this motherfucker. The solution I got for it, because, you know, I had my boy tell me, I mean, you go into a video and shit, you just sound pissed off. You got to have a solution, okay? The solution to this motherfucker is do better. Do better. You know what I'm saying? Do better. You know what I mean? Stop motherfucking not being shameful to look fucking stupid. Period. You know what I mean? I don't have a solution for a man who wants to fuck with kids, though. I don't have no solution for that shit. I'll never know what it's like. That motherfucker right there just cook his ass down. Period, point blank. You know what I mean? PPP loan scammers. Motherfucking get on the internet, try to get grant scamming ass motherfuckers. You know what I mean? They, yeah, right hand of the Klan shit. These motherfuckers. I'm going to come with a part two, and we're going to go into how the kids develop. Baby mama bullshit. The praise of crackheads on videos. Look at that. I'm reading my notes. And they're always attacking each other, like me with our opinions, right? But they would allow a, what is that, No Jumper and 1090 Jake, those two fucking clowns. And we'll get into three decades of clubbing and worshiping bullshit cinema. We're getting all that on the next parts of this Right Hand of the Klan shit. Today, this has been the LaQuinn Dickey Show, and I am out.